this statistic are going to be discussed at another talk later today. One of my colleagues, Sinead O'Moore from UMass, is going to be presenting with Ogilvy's Dermot McSweeney. And they're going to be talking about some of the findings that we have got from our member community and about moms and their spend, their habits, their behaviour, and the way they're feeling now that we've come kind of the other side of a huge change in our economy in the last few years. But I'm going to talk about statistics today. I'm just going to talk about I'm going to look at three ways that will best help your brand get your brand in front of parents and this huge spend that they are spending every day. So the three ways that I'm going to look at is being relevant, build your community, and know your community's timeline. First time expectant parents in particular are in the sense of retailer's dream. So they're starting on a journey, they're investigating all sorts of new products, and they're buying things that they've never bought before. There's a load of content put in front of them, and they're, you know, you're not really sure, do I really need this or do I not need it? And you're not always in a group of friends where you're all, you know, at the same life stage. So the customer lifetime value, if you can get an expectant parent on brand with you, is huge, because the parents, you know, if you're providing good quality content, they'll stay with you throughout their journey. I'm going to start with a recent video clip from an American company and called JetBlue. They did a really, really nice Mother's Day campaign at the beginning of this month when Mother's Day was in the States. And it acknowledges a huge problem and a huge issue for parents, which is traveling with kids. So,
it's more stressful flying with a baby. There's just a lot more to consider. There's a lot more to think about. Do I have everything ready? Am I forgetting anything? Be occupied on the airplane. I don't want to be that lady with the baby who's screaming for 4 hours.
I'm nervous because he doesn't like to sit still. I think the worst thing that could happen on this flight is that he'll get overtired, which causes a lot of strain, and he will definitely get his older clothes.
I'm most nervous about her having a total meltdown and having everyone around us really wishing that we were on the plane.
Thank you.
hear you cry on the flight, but it's a nice, it's just a nice gesture, and it shows that they understand their customers and their community. So be relevant to my first slide. Provide value always in your content. So being relevant means content that provides value to the user and the parent in this state in some way, whether it's something entertaining, informative, or a mixture of both. You can also personalize your content for your community, we do even better. So address their particular problems and solve them, make them easier and make them feel smarter and better, and delight them in the process. And I think JetBlue did that in their app there. One size does not fit all, and with parents as well, there are different life stages all the time. So what's bothering a mom with a 2 week old isn't going to be what's bothering a mom with a toddler, you know. So very specific messages as to the times. 61% of consumers are influenced by personalized content, so every side benefits from the personal touch. And users relate to it and they respond to it well. Sensitivity to exactly where a woman is in her pregnancy, for example, is really important as well. Not only will quality, authentic content and personalized if you can, will engage parents, it will also establish your site as a trustworthy source of content. And this is so, so important in every community, but especially in the parenting community, where you might spend quite a lot of money on new products and things that you haven't bought up to date. This is even more about the user experience angle. And I like to look at this in relation to when we're working on our social media strategy, our content, email strategy, all the digital channels, because essentially, every channel is your final user experience. This is a traditional, more kind of baby-related brand, Pampers. And their site is really good. It does does a really good job of providing relevant and authentic content. But they're not just talking about nappies and nappy changing. They've articles there about sleeping while you're pregnant and baby skincare, cooking with your kids. And they also have little week by week things, so you can actually put in if you were 16 weeks pregnant or 18 weeks pregnant, and get really relevant data for your information for your where you are in your state of pregnancy. So it's really nice and organizing here for the user. My next point is about building a community. So creating a community gets people talking about your brand, engaging about your brand, and that's where you can kind of build it up. I think that Jack mentioned earlier in his talk, where you can show that you care about what your community cares about. So at EU Mom, we have community forums, and in one section of forums, there's birth clubs. So when a woman finds out she's pregnant, she can join a birth club for, say, December 2016 or July 2016, whichever. And there'll be lots of moms already there who are due at the same time as her. So she can share her experience and they can swap stories, get advice from each other and things like that. It's really nice, it's pretty popular with moms when they first find out they're pregnant and they're not telling anybody yet. And they can go on here and on the state, they've just got a little nickname. And talk to other moms and say, oh my god, I just found out I'm pregnant, yay, it's mom cons all over the place. And everybody else can, they can share their joy with someone, even if they're not telling their friends and family, when they're in the circle at home. I love this quote from Ted Rubin, social media strategist, never gives your community to give you power, and I think it's really, really true. Building community is what we do as humans all the time, and it goes much further than just, gathering people around you. An online community, get people excited about something, gets them to bond, and creates that sort of word of mouth energy and peer to peer sharing that is just invaluable. Building relationships and trust for your brand, and also creates brand advocates. And advocates are extremely powerful. 92% of consumers believe that recommendations from friends and family over all forms of other advertising. So, really strong way of getting your brand to people. Danone is another site that does a really good job at actually working with minimize away from what they do is like they make babies, that's not minimize away, but they create babies and they don't really go into like their product as such online, they're more about helping the people who are using the product. And my third point then is know your finishing timeline. So you could offer your new solutions at the right time is extremely powerful. Delivering content that is timely is never more important than when you're a parent and your kids are changing all the time or when you're pregnant and your body's changing all the time. So there's a huge difference and set for a lot, let's say a woman who's 22 weeks pregnant is looking for on a website and a dad and a toddler, say. So offering real solutions at the right time will keep your community coming back to your site with a bit of trust. This is a really nice example of an off-line example of a brand who makes baby clothes. And it's a really simple little design. The company is called Rosy Hope. And they're reminding their community that they care and that they know what, you know, that they know them. This is just like the tag on the clothes, but on it has a little tip about talking to your baby and how to encourage them, just a couple of lines. And they're just showing that they understand the life stage that the parent is at and their child is at. And they're also displaying all of their social channels just to encourage that person to make that online connection with their community online as well. So take advantage of every touch point. Johnson's is a huge beauty brand, and they had, similar to Pampers, they do a load of other content on their site. And they're known for baby bathing products, but their site covers content on playtime, learning with your baby, and it gives parents, you know, looking online to their products, a more engaging image experience. Okay, this is a really quick ad. Off the bottom, I get that in every week. So she was already familiar, more or less, with the content that was in it, but she was still enjoying receiving them. So forgiving people of something relevant and showing that we care as much as possible to the life stage that they're at, we got a really high open rate in the media and click throughs that are way above the industry averages. So your greatest assets are creating your data. So creating relevant content and real solutions for your audience. Engage your community and use your data. And you have loads of it, like from your social media and insights from Facebook, Google Analytics, from your website. And you know, if you're on social media, that's an opportunity as well to talk to your community, but also to listen. Listen to what they say. Because they, you know, 9 times out of 10, they're going to be telling you what they want on social media and what they need. So this is just a summary, the end of my presentation. So just listen and reward your community, use humor, be relational, personalized, and above all, know who you're talking to and why you're communicating with them, and show that you understand them. I think that's one of the main things when you're dealing with parents, is just show that you understand, like a JetBlue commercial, you know, that you understand where the pain points are and that